Canada's tuning in. You know, D-Meds, does the name say it all? Or what is it about you that, you know, the world needs to know?
Yeah, man. If I say D-Meds, you talk about deep meditation, you know?
Ah.
Yeah, that's what it means, deep meditation. We are talking for you. If you listen to music, you know, we do message music. So, and you hear a depth of deepness, you know? Depth of spirituality. But you hear my type of music, you know what I mean? So, definitely. Over things there, you can talk about D-Meds, you know, because D-Meds been doing this for a while now, you know what I mean? Been doing this for a while now, like over more than a decade right now, and we've been doing this, you know what I mean? So,
yeah.
And right now, reaching spite now, already at Toronto now, and a promo tour now, so trying to get Toronto to get more familiar with D-Meds. But right now, in Jamaica, right now, D-Meds is one of the most talked about reggae artists right now in Jamaica right now, you know what I mean?
I'm not gonna deny the fact. You know, I ask many artists this, and I stay the lane where there's artists of culture and there's artists of dancehall.
Yeah.
And I'm going to ask you likewise again, in a world full of vibes, dancehall, that's so ever powerful.
Yeah.
How do you, you know, I know your meds is correct. How do you stay afloat knowing that, you know, the mainstream radio stations and stuff like that, they're so, how could I say, they connect or so, they so vibrant with the dancehall music and the culture music fights to get through, but you know, how do you maintain what you maintain?
Yeah, I love that question. All right, here I say now. Emails are you that come from dancehall. You know what I mean? My earlier stuff, them I have a first EP called Road Tonight, you know, more like a dancehall vibration, but not like the dancehall that we probably are here.
Right,
now.
Right.
We are around Jamaica, so you know what I mean? It was much more a dancer where people like Barry G and all these people couldn't even play. My dancer was more clean and more like fun and all them things.
Okay.
With the vibration. Still have a message in it, you know what I mean?
Of course.
Saying so, so what I do to keep relevant as a reggae artist, but it's a case where demons reach a spiritual point in my life, where I'm much more connected with the Most High, you know what I mean? I start to read my Bible more a lot, you know what I mean? I just reach a place now where we have a youth and we want to make sure so boy, we are spread the right message to the youth, you know what I mean? Because them are the future. So what I do now, see, because me have that thing from dancehall, I bring that dancehall element within my reggae music. So when you hear my reggae music, boring. You use them. Right now, No Fala is one of the biggest song right now in the school.
I'm listening to it. I like
now,
it. I'm going to get the...
When we say one of the biggest songs in the school, when they use them, I'm right now, since I'm doing a school tour right now in Jamaica called Don't Fala Bad Company,
okay,
which I'm going to different schools, you know what I mean? And right now, youths them are sing the song the word for word right now in Jamaica. So, and if you know, say, this is an original foundation rhythm from the 80s before me, probably longer than that in the 60s.
That's what makes me respect it to the max.
That's a Sir Coxon, that original real rock rhythm. And right now, me have used them a rock.
Yes.
So it's nothing. So just like how the youth them a rock to the dance, I beat them. You know, them can also rock to the reggae beat them, but you have to put the same kind of sweetness, just like where you see dance and ask them to put tweet. You know, you can't be all about the Rasta and dee. You know, you have to bring a vibe to it, so that's what I do, you know what I mean?
Something has come up in my mind, and I'm going to ask you that.
Yeah.
I want to ask a lot of artists. You know, you struggle so hard to make it in Jamaica.
Yeah.
You finally get the big break.
Yeah.
Foreign takes on your culture, foreign takes on your music, foreign loves you. Then you get to foreign and all of a sudden now you want to turn your music and change it. And I mean by changing it, I mean a lot of artists have got into the limelight and now they want to do what is like, I don't know, reggae kind of house music, reggae kind of country, reggae. They pop music,
okay,
and they want to turn the reggae music.
Yeah.
How do you feel about that when, you know, your break is coming, I know that.
Yeah.
But what happens? Why the change? Is there something that you're looking towards to? Is the roots and culture, I find they leave.
Yeah.
When it reaches a foreign capability.
Yeah.
What happens? Why? Can you
explain? Yeah, all right. My input on that and how I look at that, you know what I mean? I see we're, all right. Enough people never expect, say, are you with, you know, in my late 20s, could I come down and go up on a foundation with him and make all of the foundation artists. Actually, every artist and the River Rhythm right now, I play on Jamaica Rhythm right now.
Right.
Coco T, all these artists rise up.
You never stop.
Never stop, you know. So, So I don't know why the arts them are doing it, you know, but if I see something I work from yard, cause I believe say yard are one of the hardest place. Mm-hmm. So from yard can accept the real music. And trust me, that's what the foreigner them even love it for. I mean, that's what
people. That's what I'm saying.
So I don't know. I'm this is the first time I've been to Canada.
Right.
You know what I mean? This is my second time ever living in the country, come do a show internationally. Otherwise, I'm going to do a small island, Cayman and them places.
Okay.
So it's the first time. So I'm going to come look upon. I come see why them are coming and switch.
Okay.
So right now, all I know is why I come to Canada and I just give them demons, you know.
Right.
And I try to remain as being
deep. But you do see the switching in a lot of
bodies. I do see the switching. Don't know why them switching.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I listen to other artists and enough time in survival and I don't know if a case where the people them love the music but them not purchase the music. I don't know if that's the case because that's what I've been hearing.
That's
you know
a
know
whole
I mean?
Different show.
So I don't know if it's a case where like you would probably this thing is very hot and I love but they not actually purchase it, and if they not purchase it, whoa, that means that boy the artist
yeah,
suffer.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You see me? So probably I think that's the case. You know what I mean? Because okay. I can remember a fella, I won't call him name. I was listening to an interview with him, and he was saying when him I said, yo, why you switch up a thing and this is the artwork of Billboard. You know what I mean? Yeah. But him start out from where like me. You know what I mean?
So you understand where I'm coming from with
this? Yeah, man.
So
I was listening to the artist, and this is what the artist said, and then I was like, oh. Wasn't really
and you see, this is where I go to part B of the question is a man like you look up to those kind of artists.